So let's talk about data types in Java. More precisely, primitive data types in Java. So there are four categories: integers, floating point, character based, and boolean. So let's see what are different types of integers we have in Java. So first one is byte. Second one is short. Third one is int. And the last one is long. So these are four types of integers you can have, having different size and range, and default value will be same for all. For all integers, default value will be 0. So let's mark it. Default value for all integers will be 0. And let's talk about their size. So byte is of 1 byte, or you can say 8 bits. As you all know that 1 byte consists of 8 different bits, and the maximum value 8 bits is 255. So I'll talk about that, how size is there and how range is computed out of that size. We'll give a separate video for that, and that will be very interesting. But now let's see what are different size and ranges of data types. So next one is short. Short consists of 2 bytes and 16 bits. So these are one of the same thing. Int is of 4 bytes, very important and widely used, or 32 bits. Long is of 8 bytes or 64 bits. Now, this is very important, that how to compute range for byte. Now let's consider small diagram. So this is the diagram. So now what I've done this? What is this 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128? They're not the sizes of your pen drives, but they are basically 2 raised to power 0, 2 raised to power 1, 2 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 4, and 7. So this is what we call as binary. And now you can see these are the 8 bits, which is called as 1 byte in total. Now, how to compute this range? Now, what is the maximum value you can have using these 8 bits? You can put all 1s here, and then you can have the maximum value as 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16 plus 32 plus 64 plus 128, and you will get 255. So this is the maximum value you can obtain from 8 bits. And the minimum value, when you'll put all zeros, that will be the minimum value. So the range for 8 bits will be from 0 to 255. But this is in the case when we are having unsigned. But Java doesn't support unsigned data type. It supports signed data types. So the first bit, that is called as MSB, is always reserved. So this first bit is always reserved. And now the range goes to minus 128 to plus 127. This is very important to understand, that if I'll not consider this 128 option and I'll add 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, you will get a value positive 127. So this is how ranges are computed. And for 8 bits, in case of signed data types, you will be having minus 128 to 127. And with short, your range will be minus 32768 to positive 32767. So this is the said range for short. And for int, you can simply write it as minus 2 raised to power 31 to positive 2 raised to power 31 minus 1. And for long, minus 2 raised to power 63 to positive 2 raised to power 63 minus 1. And the default value for all the data types will be 0. And there is a separate column called as wrapper class. So the specific wrapper classes are as follows. For byte it is byte. For short it is short, S capital. Here B is capital. For int it is integer. So let me tell you the difference between integer and this integers. This is a section of these four types. But this integer is actually a class. I'll tell you more about it. Long, L capital long. So these are called as wrapper classes, which is, you can say, for every primitive data type, Java has a class for them, right? Now let's move to the second category, that is floating point. So floats are of two types. One is float, another is double, right? The size for float is 4 bytes and size for double is 8 bytes. The default value for floats are 0.0 and same is for double, 0.0. But the precision is 6 decimal places. And for double is 15 decimal places. Means you can have 6 digits after the decimal, and in case of double you can have 15 digits after the decimal. And wrapper classes for float is F capital float and for double is T capital. The next category is character based, and for that the type is char and the size is 2 bytes or 16 bits. It's the only range which is unsigned range. Rest all ranges in Java are signed ranges, but for character it is unsigned and it is from 0 to 65535. And the default character value is mu. And the wrapper class for character is character, C capital. The last category is Boolean. Denoted as Boolean, B small, primitive data, B small, and its size is 1 bit only, and it is JVM dependent. The range is only 2 values, true or false, and the default value is false. The wrapper class is Boolean. So these are the set data types. I'll talk about range of float and double in a separate video because it will take some time. We'll talk about this section in a separate video because it will take time. So let's sum up the video again. What are the different data types? There are four categories: integer, floating point, character and Boolean based. So firstly, in integers there are four types: byte, short, int and long. For floating point there is float and double. For character based it is char only, C small, and for Boolean it is Boolean. Now respectively size is 1, 2, 4, 8 and for float 4 and 8 bytes, and for char it's 2 bytes. Generally in C++ and C we have character as 1 byte, but that has a limited set of characters only, that is English language and some symbols, that keyboard symbols. But Java supports universalization and the support is called as Unicode. So Java works on Unicode, or you can say internationalization, where all the language set of the world, let's suppose Chinese, French, Dutch, Punjabi, all languages are adjusted in this character set. Thank you so much for watching. Next topic will be how these ranges are computed, both signed and unsigned. In this video we are going to talk about number format systems. We have four types of number systems. First one is binary number system, second one is decimal number system, third one is octal number system, and fourth one is hexadecimal number system. So today we are only going to talk about the first two, that is decimal number system and binary number system. So decimal number system, let me ask you a question. Let's say how many rupees you have in your pocket right now. So let's say it is 547. So how we say that you are having 547 rupees. So let's see that. Basically, the base value is 10. Why 10? Because in decimal number system, we have a range from 0 to 9. Means, what are the primary constituents of this set? They are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's it. So these are the 10 digits. That is why the base value is 10. So it starts from 10 raised to power 0, 10 raised to power 1, 10 raised to power 2. Now what is 10 raised to power 0? It's 1. What is 10 raised to power 1? It's 10. What is 10 raised to power 2? It's 100. So how we proceed now? So we multiply this main term 7 with 1, which gives you 7 plus 10 into 4, 40 plus 100 into 5, that is 500. So that's why we say that you are having 547 rupees. The same is with binary. But now in binary number system, what is the possible values you can have? You can have only two values, 0, 1. So that is why the base is 2. So now let's suppose I am having a binary number. So let's say 1, 1, 0, 1. Now let's suppose it is a positive number only, and I'm not taking any MSB as negative sign yet. So this is only a positive number. So what can I do? This is 2 raised to power 0, 2 raised to power 1, 2 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 3. And what is 2 raised to power 0? It's 1, it's 2, it's 4, it's 8. Now how to compute the value? So 1 into 1, 1 plus 0 into 2, 0. Plus 1 into 4, 4. Plus 8 into 1, 8. What is the value? Value is 13. So, binary of 1, 1, 0, 1 will give you a decimal number of 13. So, let's see that how with different bits, what can be the range. Now, let's consider only 3 bits. So these are all 8 possible combinations you can have with 3 bits. Now let's see how to have value. So this will be 000, which will give you 0 as answer. This will be 1 only. This will be 2. This will be 3. This will be 4, 5, 6 and 7. How? Because this is 2 raised to power 0, 2 raised to power 1, 2 raised to power 2. Let's consider this case. 1 into 1, 1 plus 1 into 2, 3 plus 0 into 4, 0. So 0 plus 2, 0 plus 2 plus 1 will give you 3 is answer. So this is the case when we have unsigned data type. So now the number of bits were 3. So 2 raised to power 3. The formula for computing the unsigned range is 0 to 2 raised to power n minus 1, where n is the number of bits. So as you can see, this is having 3 bits and the total range you are getting out of it is 0 to 2 raised to power, what is n? N is 3. So 3 minus 1. So 0 to 7 is the answer. So with 3 bits, you are having this unsigned range. With 4 bits, you can have 0 to 15. With 5 bits, you will be having 0 to 63. And same with 8 bits, that is 1 byte, you can have a range from 0 to 255. But this is all about unsigned range. Now let's talk about signed ranges. What happens in signed ranges? In signed ranges, the first bit, the MSB. What is MSB? Most significant bit. Most significant bit here will be this 4 value. Out of these 3 bits, it is 1, 2, 4. So 4 is the most significant bit. So this bit will be reserved. Now what is the purpose of it? If the value of MSB is 0, then the number is considered as positive. If the value of MSB is 1, then the number is considered as negative. So how that thing is computed? So in this case, in case of signed data type, what will be the values? This all are four are positive numbers. So 0, 1, 2, 3. But this will be what? This is actually 1 and 0. This will not be minus 0, but this will be minus 4. And this will be minus 3. This will be minus 2. And this will be minus 1. This is very important to understand that 1, 0, 0 will not give you minus 0. There is nothing like minus 0. This will give you minus 4, minus 3, minus 2 and minus 1. Same. In this case, you can derive a formula for signed data types that will be minus 2 raised to power n minus 1 to 2 raised to power n minus 1 minus 1. With this formula, you can compute the range of a signed data type, and this will be the unsigned range. I hope you have liked the video. Any questions, any comments, you can mention in the comment section.